deep in the ESPN tape library. The worldwide leader in classic sports launched a series designed to take a new look at old games. They called it Cheap Seats with Ron Parker. Parker, an anchor with attitude, was helped thanklessly by tape librarians Randy and Jason. The show was slated to go all the way. But moments into the first show, tragedy struck. With Ron on the DL, somebody needed to step up, like Gehrig for Pip or Brady for Bledsoe. Sitting 2 and 3 on the hosting depth chart, that someone was Randy and Jason. That is their story. And this is Cheap Seats without Ron Parker.
Welcome to Cheap Seats. I'm Randy. This is Jason. And today we're going to watch the 1978 Superstars. For those of you who might not remember, the Superstars pitted the best athletes from different sports against each other in a variety of events. It's kind of like Battle of the Network Stars, minus Gabe Kaplan's pulled groin. Now, today's competition took place on Grand Bahama Island, and it includes some of the most dynamic sports icons of all time, like Wayne Grimditch. Now, before we get into the actual Superstars events, let's meet the athletes involved.
My name is Ben Davidson. I played defensive line for the Oakland Raiders.
In 1927.
Very effectively. My name is Deacon Jones, former Secretary of Defense.
Before Donald Rumsfeld?
Number 75.
I'm Don Maynard.
Schneider.
New York Jets.
I'm Bob Beamon, the world record holder in the long jump.
And resident village person.
Village holder of the world's water ski jumping record of 180 feet.
Hi, I'm Tom Sneva.
Looks like Bill Gates.
Yeah, only nerdy. Word.
Hi, I'm Dwight Stones, two-time Olympic bronze medalist.
This guy puts the white in Dwight.
Ron Say, third baseman, Los Angeles Dodgers.
Hi, I'm Steve Garvey, first baseman for the Los Angeles Dodgers.
David Casper, tight end, Oakland Raiders.
I'm Mark Van Egan, running back for the Oakland Raiders.
Okay, laziest talent bookers ever. Clearly, they did not look beyond California. Now, in the actual superstar competition, the superstars gain points by winning the athletic events. And that's fine.
That's cool.
We're not against it. But in our little side competition, Randy and I will be searching for the coolest superstar. So throughout the show, we'll be periodically
and arbitrarily
giving and taking away cool points. For example, check out Ben Davidson's intro again.
My name is Ben Davidson. I played defensive line for the Oakland Raiders. Very effectively.
See, that's some serious hubris, and you're going to lose about 5 cool points for that. On the other hand, Greg Pruitt's got the gold tooth. That'll at least get him about 5.7 cool points. Now, at the end of the episode, Randy and I will crown the coolest superstar, or as we like to call it, the cooler star.
I actually wanted to call it the Cooper Stars.
And that's why I make 75 cents more per hour.
Let's get to the action.
Joining me today, Bill Russell, Bruce Tinner, Reggie Jackson. And Deacon Dave Jones, he has already told us he is quite a swimmer. Deacon, swimming with goggles.
Lynn, your husband seems like a good athlete.
Well, he's actually my brother.
Oh, really?
Good start.
Look at that dive. That's gotta hurt.
Runs to the middle. Wayne Grimditch eases to the front. Furthest from you, Mark Van Egan. Ben Davidson is third. And Deacon Jones is having problems.
What did Deacon say before the race?
You a good swimmer?
Oh, yeah, I can swim pretty good.
Where? In your bathtub? I blame the goggles.
Mixed up the super team, Bill. Wayne Grimditch on top.
This race is like that scene from Breaking Away.
Mark Van Egan.
Yeah, let's hope there's not a refrigerator at the bottom of the pool.
In the second heat of the swimming, Wayne Grimditch all the way, followed by Mark Van Egan and Ben Davidson and Deacon.
Oh, Deacon.
And we're just about ready. Dwight Stone's the favorite. 2 lengths of the pool, 50 yards. The final will be 100 yards. And they're off. Steven gets a good start. But it's Dwight Stone.
All right, this is boring. We got to fast forward it.
Dwight, you looked effortlessly in that one.
Oh, it felt good.
Effortlessly. Obviously, grammar was not one of the events in the decathlon.
It is, but you were so smooth. It looked like he was working awful hard, especially at the
awful
end.
Hard.
At the good turn, I save a lot of energy on the turn, so... The hundreds of my race, like running the quarter.
All
right. Well, good luck in the finals, then.
Thanks, Bruce.
Now, even though we gave Jenner some grammatical flack in that last segment, we should note that he's probably the most famous and arguably the best male decathlete of all time.
If it's not easy for American decathletes since Jenner to follow in his footsteps, imagine how hard it is for one of his less talented relatives.
We invite you now to meet Nicholas Jenner, aspiring decathlete.
I didn't choose the decathlon. The decathlon chose me. It's in my blood. I'm Nicholas Jenner, and I'm a decathlete. Bruce Jenner was my uncle. I grew up with him in my life. We all know Bruce. There he is right there. Happy guy. I knew that smile when I was a kid. I used to see it. It used to make me want to run and javelin and dash. That's my smile, too. See that? This is a stopwatch that Bruce gave me for Christmas, and I use it to improve my time on everything. I carry it around with me wherever I go, and I just time it, get it tight, get my life tight. I came up with a theory studying my uncle throughout the years. To be a great decathlete, you don't have to be great at 10 events. You have to be pretty good. You know what I mean? Not even 10. I mean 7 events. You can let 3 slide. I'm going to carry on my uncle's legacy. I've decided and be a decathlete myself. You know, I think I can do my uncle proud. I think maybe that'll be me on a board game someday. I'll be running, crossing the finish line. That's America. I love you. Nicholas. So what are the 7 events you're pretty good at? The dash. One where you run. Yeah, the 100 meter dash. Which I cut down to 5. Because 100 is too long. Long jump. I'm working on that one. It's pretty long right now. Probably not going to be super long. The shot put, which is a classic decathlon event, and I changed it because I couldn't find a shot put. I didn't know where to get one. And then when somebody did give one to me, it was really, really heavy. So I substituted it with a cookie, and that was a lot easier, a lot lighter. So now I do a cookie put instead of a shot put. You can also eat the cookie at the end of the event, which, you know, you can't dip a shot put in milk. I start off every day, wake up, and write a letter to the Olympic Committee trying to get them to accept my events. The response has been a unanimous no. Is that even your real hair? Yeah, of course it's my real hair. Ow. I'm gonna do it. So close I can taste it right now. Whatever games, the Olympics, the Pan Am Games, the Senior Games, I'll be there. When I'm there, I'm gonna have a cookie in my hand. Bet your dollar on that.
Welcome back to Cheap Seats.
All right, let's recap the cool race standings. Now, Dwight Stones picked up 4 points for hitting on Grimditch's sister. And Deacon picked up 12 cool points for his long stroke. Okay, let's get back to the competition. Dwight Stones took the finals in swimming, and Frank Gifford interviewed the ever-controversial athlete.
Dwight Stones is always at the forefront of controversy in the arena.
Hello, Dwight Stones.
Personality of intensity.
It's Joshua. Would you like to play a game?
In all of his actions in the high jump. Recently,
does anyone know who Valerie Brummel is?
I have no idea.
Does anyone know who Valerie Brummel is?
No one? Oh, I know who would know.
The Answer Dog.
Keeps telling him 82 when the Cardinals play the Brewers. Randy bought a special frame just as Milwaukee sang. So they took the winner home and raised him as their very own. It's not quite a Brewers dog, it's the Answer Dog.
Shut up!
Dog.
Answer Dog. Thanks for stopping
by. Hey, easy. I just got this bun a week ago.
Well, it's very slimming. Yeah, you look great.
All right, cut the kissing.
All right, here's our question. World champion high jumper Dwight Stones.
Yeah, I know. I know who Dwight Stones is.
He claimed that his favorite athlete was Valerie Brummel, and we've never heard of her. Who is she?
First of all, dummies, it's a he.
Oh.
Secondly, he's only one of the most famous Russian Olympic high jumpers in history. 1960 silver medalist, 1964 gold medalist. Gold is better than silver in case you've never seen the Olympics.
Yeah, we've seen the Olympics.
And he recently died. So how about some respect for the dead people? Can I go now?
Well, thank you very much, Answer Dog.
Shut up!
Whoa. Hey, whatever, dog. Let's get back to the action.
Dwight, there was a recent article that came out in the New York Times stating that the monies that you had earned here at the finals and the superstars was going to have to go back to the AAU. I'm sure before you came down here, you looked up what the ruling is on this, and what was your opinion at that time?
Well, as usual, I don't go into anything without knowing all the facts because...
Because I'm a know-it-all and I'm annoying.
It's shady in some areas. You can overstep your boundaries, so... I called the Secretary General at the International Amateur Athletic Federation in London.
Why did nobody cut this down? Yeah, we should sell Dwight Stone's interviews as insomnia relief packs. Yeah, but he does kind of look like a young Christy Todd Whitman there.
That the money earned in Superstars could go to the athlete's club or to any charity that he wanted to. Who was that at the IAAF? His name is John Holt, and he's the Secretary General of the IAAF, and he's very much on the side of amateur athletes, track athletes especially. And I asked him on several occasions, are you sure that I can be in it without jeopardizing my amateur status? Because I'd still like to high jump a couple more years. There is another Olympic Games coming up in a couple more years, and... does the money go to the governing body, or does it go? Can it go to the track club or a charity? He says, absolutely, it can go to your track club. I'm a member of the Desert Oasis Track Club in Palm Springs. It's a bona fide California corporation.
Oh, by the way, at the time, Dwight Stones was the only member of the Desert Oasis Track Club, so... Fortunately, he's not involved in the next event, so let's head out to the weightlifting competition. Deacon Jones. More like Weakin Jones.
Ooh, Deacon is unhappy. I'd hate to be the official that he gets unhappy with.
Why? Deacon can't even lift 220 pounds over his head. The official can probably kick his ass. But I am impressed with the fact that instead of a weight belt, Deacon wore his own belt.
The members of the fearsome foursome of the late 60s and the early 70s. He played the game at one speed, 110%.
That's not a speed.
He retired from the mayhem of pro football in 1973. He is now a public relations director of a medical supply company in Los Angeles.
Okay, Deacon Jones was like the Reggie White of his day.
Minus the racism.
And now he's like selling syringes and catheters? What the hell's going on?
Well, you'd be ashamed of, although I don't have one of the Super Bowl rings, which I so desperately wanted. I can say some things that no other ball player in the history of the game.
Deacon, when you get a chance, we need more balls, pads.
The fact that I'm not going to ever have a Super Bowl ring.
Oh, in a case of saline solution?
The rest of my life. But one thing about it, I don't know too many guys that may... All pro 10 times.
See me in my office after you're done with this interview.
So change the course of defensive football. And that I'm proud of.
David Jones, the very best at what he did.
Taking off his helmet. Come on. Warren Sapp will never be caught dead selling futons at IKEA after his career. But still, we salute you, Deacon. We respect that you did what you had to do to survive. I still gotta knock him down some cool points. I mean, rules is rules, baby. Randy, come on! I can't believe you would do that to Deacon! He should be here. You're right. You're right.
I know I'm right.
Whoa. That was weird. How did we get back here?
Well, I pushed the hyperspace button. Okay?
Oh.
So, yeah. Okay. Anyway, our show's only a half an hour, which means that sometimes we have to cut some of the good stuff.
But we saved it for you in a little figurative formaldehyde jar in a segment we like to call What Got Cut? You missed this cord wrangler getting electrocuted shortly after a Frank Gifford interview. You missed Andy Rooney getting out of a boat.
You ever wonder why they call it seasickness? I'm on a lake.
There was a celebrity sighting. Sadly, even the Chiron failed to spark excitement. Dave Casper enjoyed half of many, many, many refreshments. Ron Say took a break from bowling to detail Sneva's car. And Wayne Grimditch managed to become the favorite to win the Superstars by winning the bike race and the grueling half-mile run. Although I'm predicting a Deacon upset.
Or that he'll do something that'll make us feel upset.
Probably.
All right, more cheap seats right after this.
I don't know. I give him credit. And hanging in it? Just that in the first 9 seasons of the Superstars, the 3 leading money winners were a pole vaulter, a water ski champion, and a soccer player.
Do you care that in 1972, Reggie Jackson was reportedly the first baseball player with facial hair in 58 years?
Do you care that in 1978, Bill Berge was the highest paid linebacker in football with a 4-year, $1 million contract?
$1 million in 4 years? You can't even get Ray Lewis to come to your bar mitzvah for that kind of money today.
Well, maybe his entourage.
And a breakdancing robot. All right, let's get back to the action.
It's the kind of competition that brings out that whatever, that unknown force that makes these great athletes so competitive. You can't tell. Dave Casper here, he could finish second.
Does Bill know something that we don't know?
What he has in reserve.
Hey, sexy.
It's hard to pick these guys now.
Don Maynard, a former teammate of mine and a great jet receiver.
Yeah, he'll be tested in this race. It'll be like running the 40 against a bunch of place kickers.
I think they might be chasing him all the way.
Garvey's hair looks like the hair that goes on a Lego guy.
First, rather quickly. And Bill Berge.
Look, it's the big mute villain from Superman 2.
Yeah, he was just released from a parallelogram hurtling through space.
5-hole like no middle linebacker in football today, but that's only about 4 yards.
And I bet you, no matter what happens, no one's going to have as much fun as Bill Berge's having, because he is really enjoying himself.
Garvey with a good jump is off to the lead.
Check out Ron Say on the far left. His running coach was like, whatever you do, don't bend your knees while you're running.
Second is Casper and Garvey. It's Garvey and Casper. Is Pruitt the winner? Garvey and Dave Casper.
Steve Garvey had a great anticipation here. He anticipated when the...
He did, but I wouldn't say his performance was Hall of Fame worthy.
But as you see, Greg Pruitt kind of pulls away.
I feel like Ron Say just lit a fire between his thighs.
How about the middle linebacker of the Philadelphia Eagles giving his wife Mickey a little kiss and talking to his youngster?
Deal before Zod.
Bruce has moved over to Bill right now.
Well, big Bill Berge may not have won the 100-yard dash, but I say we give him another chance with the golf competition.
Give it before Zod.
He's on the tee right now. Colorful, animated, just as he is on a football field. Interesting man. He can be so lovable.
Lovable?
So much fun.
Is there something you want to share with us, Frank?
I
hope.
Ship before Zod.
And he almost had a hole in one. That ball right over.
It's like the Incredible Hulk with a golf club.
Celebrate before Zod.
Maynard back to second. Stones to third.
He's got a good follow through, though.
And this one's looking even better.
Oh, my Zod.
Bergie is wondering who's hitting the ball.
Wait, is Reggie Jackson shirtless? Reginald Martinez Jackson is shirtless, people. He is representing the network.
You are not at a picnic, buddy. This is your job.
Come on!
How about a little decorum, Reg?
Wayne Grimnidge, first place, 37 points. If he can get at least third place, he is the 1978 Superstars champion. It's as simple as that. The question is, can he do it?
Well, we'll find out the answer to Frank's burning question in a minute, but first, let's check out this musical tribute to the ever-graceful Deacon Jones that the Superstars staff put together.
We had nothing to do with it.
Slip sliding away. Slip sliding away.
Okay, this is sadder than Schindler's List.
More the nearer your destination, the more you slip sliding away.
Yeah, it's the wall, Deacon. Painful.
He wore his passion for his woman like a thorny crown.
When you're as good as David Jones, you don't need to climb over a wall.
Or do you?
We can help you.
Yeah, sure, Deacon. We'll help you get over the wall, or we'll just turn your failures into a hilarious Benny Hill skit. Well, as much as I hate to do it, I feel like we need to cut our Cooler Star losses here. Sorry, Deke. All right, let's talk a little Pruitt here. Now, if Greg wins the obstacle course, he's got a good shot at the overall title, too. And that's going to put some pressure on WG. That's what all the water ski betties like to call Grimnidge. All right, when we come back, we'll watch Pruitt in action and crown the 1978 Superstars champion, and more importantly, the Cooler Stars champion. Now, I thought Van Egan should have been right. No, he's
all right. Yeah, he's okay.
Bergie, get him up a little bit. Welcome back. Here are the standings for the Superstars. But more importantly, here are the standings for the Cooper Stars. Pruitt is leading, and short of a total meltdown in the obstacle course, he's got it on lock. Sneva, well on his way to developing Windows XP, is in a close second. And Bergie as Zod is third. Actually, hold on, Ren. You've been saying Zod all day, and that's wrong. He looks like Nan. Terrence Stamp is the actor who played Zod, and he doesn't look anything like Bergie.
Yeah, but everyone knows what you're talking about when you say Zod.
Yeah, but it's wrong.
But it's cool.
But it's wrong.
But it's cool.
But it's wrong.
But it's cool.
All right, I guess it is kind of cool.
Yeah.
All right, let's get our obstacle course on, huh?
Break through a trail team by 70. Must get to the finals of Reggie Jackson. One thing about the obstacle course, you can't let the pressure get you because it'll throw your rhythm off.
Well, there's no question about it, Frank. I've been down here many times, and I've seen the great ones come up and still make...
Check out Don Maynard. He's kind of old, kind of dirty, kind of greasy. Yeah, he's like that guy in your neighborhood who's always working in his garage, always talking about his divorce, breathing on you with that beer breath.
Football with ease.
Hey, we see Pruitt.
Since when is a tunnel an obstacle? A tunnel is used to get through an obstacle.
Through the tires, and he's on there. Oh, he may have had a problem.
This whole thing feels like a four-year-old's birthday party.
Over the...
Only less fun.
His way, Frank.
Greg Pruitt, he has great time, but a flag is up back by the tires.
Someone's got a nice new choker.
But a flag is up by the tires. Now get over and have a word with him, Reggie.
Well, this should be a great interview with Reggie. He seems to be able to get answers out of everybody.
Is that called, They say they have a penalty back up by the tires. Either the...
Good interview, Reg.
The tires or where the water jump is. We'll find out in just a minute, Greg. You looked like you were flying low to the ground. You do not think that you missed a tire. It's on TV.
I love that Pruitt says it's on TV, and that's what indicts him the most. Where's the strategy of that, Greg?
23.21 seconds. Here he goes, working the tires.
Really, when do they ever do the tire drill in football anyway?
No problem there. And it was this last tire. Watch his left foot. There it is. And, Reggie, there's no question about it.
Well, absolutely.
It's on TV. It's on TV.
Touch the ground with your foot and not just the tire.
Greg Snafu cost him the championship, which ended up going to everyone's favorite superstar, Wayne Grimditch. I think Pruitt's outburst makes him cooler. He was keeping it real out there, showing some emotion. No way. Pruitt's outburst was anything but cool. Reggie was just trying to do his job, and Pruitt totally blew him off, okay? That's gonna lose you some cool points. What do you say we give the Cooper Star crown to Sneva, huh? Now that's something I can get on board with. Now, let's give out some cheapies.
Okay.
Here's my least valuable play. Casper not finishing his business. And I'm going to have to give my most valuable cord wrangler. This was a tough decision for me. I'm giving it to this guy. Well, that's our show for today. And if we've learned anything that we can pass along to the kids, it's that sports, or any competition for that matter, is not about winning or losing, but about how cool you look while you're doing it. Well, for everyone here at Cheap Seats and 78 Superstars, James Harris, Zod, and Andy Rooney, this is Jason and Randy wishing you a happy and healthy week.